My project is incorporating two main components, waste management and urban agriculture and on-campus food production. So I've built six aquaponic systems. They're designed to test the hypothesis that we can feed fish in an aquaponic system leftover food scraps that have been pelletized instead of feeding them commercial fish feed. So I guess aquaponics is when you combine both aquaculture and hydroponics to form a sustainable food production system. You're taking the fish waste that's producing the aquaculture component, constantly pumping it up to your hydroponic grow bed, and using the fish waste as a fertilizer to grow lettuce and other plants. And then in that, by doing so, they'll clean the water and that water can go back into the aquaculture fish tank. So you're eliminating the need for synthetic fertilizers. You're eliminating the discharge for a discharge from the aquaculture, because a lot of times when you're doing commercial fish operations, they're just discharging the nutrient-rich wastewater right into local lakes and streams. So we're eliminating that, and we're greatly reducing the amount of water that is required to constantly add into the system. So basically, in traditional commercial fish feed, they harvest fish from the ocean. So they're constantly harvesting smaller, low food chain fish just to grind up and to make a fish feed for the aquaculture industry. It's a very unsustainable practice. I mean, everyone knows that the world's oceans are being overfished. Not to mention that we're in Syracuse, New York. The nearest ocean is several hundred miles away. So the idea is, what we have a lot of in Syracuse and in any urban environment is food waste. So we're going to try to look at supplementing the commercial fish feed with the food waste pellets. Now, I will perform an economic analysis on it, and we're going to compare both taking into account the cost of making the fish feed and looking at the growth rates of the fish between the two different types of feed. The whole idea is, as our population is growing, and even if it's shrinking, we're still seeing this suburban sprawl continuing to happen, taking up valuable farmland. In the process, core urban areas are left uninhabited. So the whole idea is, with these vacant properties, vacant buildings that we have, why not take an urban agriculture approach? Now, aquaponics is great because you're going to be able to produce a large amount of fruits and vegetables and a protein source in a small amount of area. So, and it's closer to the customers. So we're going to be closer to the restaurants, to the residents that live there. We have a farm stand right out in front in the middle of an urban area, and especially lower income neighborhoods where a lot of times they don't have access to fresh vegetables. They have only a convenience store selling processed food, as this is a great alternative for them. So we're growing tilapia fish. It's a few main reasons. One, they're used a lot in the aquaponics industry, so my research will have broader applications to all of aquaponics. Two, they're hard to kill, basically. They live in lower dissolved oxygen levels. They can handle pH fluctuations and nutrient fluctuations easier than other fish. They're a light white-colored flaky fish, makes it extremely marketable. Not that real fishy flavor, so a lot of people like to buy them. And so they work great in a lot of regards to that. I'm planning on growing them for about 1 year and reach a market size of 1 pound. In traditional aquaculture industries, they're able to raise tilapia from fingerlings, which is only a few inches big, is how I got mine, to a full 1 pound fish in about a year. So I'm attempting to grow my fish just as quick as that. We're growing a Boston lettuce, or bib lettuce as it's sometimes called. Basically, it's a fast growing leafy greens. Leafy greens have a high demand for nitrogen uptake. So instead of growing a tomatoes or a cucumber plant, which totally can be grown in an aquaponic system, we're just sticking with the green leafy vegetables. They grow quick, they use up a lot of nitrogen, and in a market situation, you could sell the head of organic lettuce for $3 or $4, so they have good end retail value. We have a water pump constantly pumping up water to our hydroponic grow bed. Inside the fish tank, the water is 50 gallons of water, and that's pumped up into a grow bed, which is a 25-gallon grow bed, but only 8 gallons of water can be held in there due to the gravel being there. It takes about 10 minutes to fill that grow bed up, and then after it fills, it only takes about a minute to drain. And that's a constant cycle around the clock, a 10-minute fill, 1-minute drain, nonstop. In that process, it's removing the nitrogen through the lettuce. When it gets to the top of the grow bed, it's activated. It's a bell siphon, is called. It uses pretty much gravity to act like a siphon. So when the water gets to a certain level, the siphon will activate, drain the whole tank, and then when it gets low enough, it'll break the siphon, and that just allows it to constantly run. The only other components in the system besides the water pump is an air stone with an air pump connected to it to put in enough oxygen to supply the fish, and a water heater, because tilapia are warm water fish. This lettuce is kind of old, so it's bitter. Because basically, I was growing this lettuce for a few weeks before we put the fish in, so when the fish came, there'd be a constant uptake of nitrogen right away. We wouldn't let nutrients accumulate in the system. But because I did that, this lettuce is now going on 4, 5, and 6 weeks old. But when it's growing in full production mode, I'll be able to get a full head of lettuce in only 1 week, or I'm sorry, in 4 weeks. So, and it's supposed to be great lettuce. So I've had a little bit of the lettuce. It's kind of bitter right now, but I have faith that it'll be delicious when it's in full operation, I hope.